A very good morning, friends. Today we will discuss about an important vitamin, that is thiamine. This is first vitamin to be discovered in the vitamin B complex. That's why the name is given B1. It is also known as anti beriberi vitamin and also known as anti neuritic vitamin, because it helps in prevention of beriberi and it also prevents peripheral neuropathy. That's why it is known as anti neuritic vitamin. The active form of thiamine or coenzyme of the thiamine is thiamine pyrophosphate. In chemistry, it is pyrimidine ring attached to thiazole ring. It is pyrimidine plus thiazole connected by methylene bridge. This structure, that is pyrimidine and thiazole, it is known as thiamine. And in addition to the thiamine, there is attachment of 2-phosphate. That's why it is known as thiamine pyrophosphate. And this is an active form of thiamine, which is responsible for various biochemical reactions. Now coming to the biochemical functions of thiamine, it is due to the active form of enzyme, that is coenzyme thiamine pyrophosphate. So biochemical functions. Thiamine has two important roles in our body. The first is it is responsible for energy generation. And second important function of thiamine is transmission of nerve impulse. So these are the two important functions of thiamine in our body. This thiamine is required for cleavage of carbon-carbon bond. It is required for decarboxylation reactions of alpha keto acids. Also, it is required for the transketolase reaction. In HMP shunt. So these are the two important reactions catalyzed by the thiamine. First one is the decarboxylation reactions and second one is the transketolase reaction. We will discuss these reactions. First, thiamine is required for decarboxylation of alpha keto acid, for example pyruvate. It is converted into acetyl coenzyme A. Here is the oxidative decarboxylation in which this NAD is converted into NADH. With the help of thiamine pyrophosphate, this is the first reaction catalyzed by pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. This one is the multi-enzyme complex. The similar reaction, alpha-ketoglutarate get converted into succinyl coenzyme A. Reaction catalyzed by alpha-ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. So these two important reaction catalyzed by the pyruvate dehydrogenase and alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase require thiamine. Another important reaction is branch chain alpha keto acid dehydrogenase. It is involved in metabolism of branch chain amino acid, that is valine, leucine and isoleucine. So these are the three important reactions. These reactions are responsible for generation of NADH, and this NADH goes into the electron transport chain and responsible for generation of ATP. In this way, thiamine is useful in the generation of energy. Second important function of thiamine is it is required for transmission of nerve impulse. The exact mechanism behind the transmission of nerve impulse by the thiamine is not known. Important reaction catalyzed by the thiamine is transketolase reaction. In the HMP shunt, there are two transketolase reaction in the HMP shunt. They are catalyzed by the transketolase with the help of coenzyme thiamine pyrophosphate. So this is all about the biochemical function of thiamine. Coming to the sources, the important dietary source of thiamine is unpolished rice. The important source is unpolished rice. Polishing of the rice removes near about 80% of thiamine. It is present in outer aleurone layer of the rice, and when we polish the rice, it get removed. Near about 80% of thiamine removed by polishing of the rice. Then it is present in whole wheat. It is present in whole grain, and it is also present in yeast. In non-vegetarian sources, it is present in liver, kidney, etc. So these are the important sources of thiamine. Coming to the recommended dietary allowances, it is 0.5 milligram per 1000 calorie intake. Or it is in 1 to 1.5 milligram per day. That is the requirement of thiamine daily. To the deficiency manifestations of thiamine, the first one is the causes of beriberi. Deficiency of thiamine causes beriberi. Coming to the causes, first important cause is nutritional deficiency or inadequate intake of thiamine in the diet. That is due to the excessive consumption of unpolished rice as a staple diet. This is the first. Then cooking also decreases the activity of thiamine, and there is lot of thiaminase which is present in tea and coffee, which causes theoretical deficiency of thiamine. Then coming to the second important cause, that is chronic alcoholic. In chronic alcoholic, there are two reasons of thiamine deficiency. The first one is the decreased absorption of thiamine, and second, it interferes with the conversion of thiamine to thiamine pyrophosphate. Because of these two important reasons, in chronic alcoholic there is deficiency of thiamine. Then other causes include hyperemesis gravidarum. Severe form of hyperemesis gravidarum leads to the deficiency of thiamine in infant. And in diuretic therapy, there is loss of thiamine through urine that causes nutritional deficiency of thiamine. So these are the four important causes of thiamine deficiency. Thiamine deficiency leads to the important disorder that is known as beriberi. There are different types of beriberi. Coming to the beriberi. Beriberi means weakness. There are different types of beriberi. Coming to the first, that is dry beriberi. The important manifestation in dry beriberi is weakness, and peripheral neuropathy. So these are the two important symptoms in dry beriberi. In wet beriberi, the serious manifestations are there. They are represented as breathlessness and palpitation. There is accumulation of fluid in the pericardial space. There is edema of leg. In serious manifestation, it is represented as breathlessness and palpitation. The predominant serious manifestations are cardiac dilatation and cardiomyopathies. That is cardiomyopathies and dilatation of heart. So these are the important findings in the wet beriberi. It involves CVS and there is edema of the leg. That is known as wet beriberi. And third important form of beriberi, that is known as infantile beriberi. In this infantile beriberi, the serious manifestations are important. It involves the infant, and acute fulminant form of this infantile beriberi are acute fulminant serious manifestation. It is known as Shoshin beriberi. So these are the different types of beriberi, that is dry beriberi, wet beriberi and infantile beriberi. Along with these symptoms, there is polyneuropathy. This is the first, second, third, this is the fourth, fifth important is, there is polyneuritis. An important syndrome is related to this thiamine deficiency. In chronic alcoholic, it is known as Wernicke Korsakoff syndrome. This is specially in the chronic alcoholic, that is Wernicke Korsakoff syndrome. You can remember the symptoms of this Wernicke encephalopathy with the help of this mnemonic, that is Goa MP. These are the symptoms of Wernicke's encephalopathy. and these are the symptoms of Korsakoff psychosis. It includes global confusion, ophthalmoplegia, nystagmus is there, and cerebellar ataxia. Along with in Korsakoff syndrome, there is memory loss and psychosis. So these are the important clinical manifestations due to the deficiency of thiamine in chronic alcoholics leads to the disorder known as Wernicke's encephalopathy and Korsakoff psychosis. Combined, it is known as Wernicke's Korsakoff syndrome, characterized by these symptoms, that is GOVA MP, global confusion, ophthalmoplegia, ataxia, memory loss and psychosis. These are the symptoms of Wernicke's Korsakoff syndrome in chronic alcoholic. The important reason for deficiency of thiamine in alcoholic is it decreases the absorption of thiamine from the intestine and it interferes with the conversion of thiamine to thiamine pyrophosphate. Due to this, it hampers the energy metabolism, and due to hampering the energy metabolism, it decreases the formation of ATP. You know the important reaction catalyzed by the thiamine pyrophosphate, that is pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, in which pyruvate is converted into acetyl coenzyme A and there is generation of NADH. Also there is generation of NADH in the reaction catalyzed by the alpha ketoglutarate dehydrogenase. Due to deficiency of NADH, as this NADH is responsible for production of ATP in the electron transport chain, there is deficiency of ATP. And the heart and brain, these are the important tissue which requires large amount of ATP for their action. That's why these are the principal tissues which are involved in the beriberi, that is nervous system and cardiovascular system. So this is all about the deficiency manifestation caused by the thiamine, that is dry beriberi, wet beriberi, infantile beriberi, Shoshin beriberi, polyneuritis and Wernicke's Korsakoff syndrome. Coming to the treatment part, in the treatment, 100 mg of thiamine is given per day for 7 days and then 10 mg per day until the full recovery of the symptoms. So this is the treatment part of the thiamine. Summarizing the thiamine, it is also known as anti-beriberi vitamin or anti-neuritic vitamin. The active form is thiamine pyrophosphate. It is required for energy metabolism and also required for the transmission of nerve impulse. In deficiency of thiamine, these are the different beriberi, that is dry, wet and infantile beriberi, along with this syndrome, that is Wernicke's Korsakoff syndrome. Coming to the sources, unpolished rice is important source of thiamine for us, but polishing removes near about 80% of the thiamine activity. In causes of beriberi, the important one is the decreased intake, then chronic alcoholism, diuretic therapy and hyperemesis gravidarum. These are the important causes of thiamine deficiency. This is all about the thiamine.